Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1669, Subtotal in Footer with VBA. Hey, to download the macro from today's podcast, go to MrExcel.com/podcast1669.html. That's all lowercase. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. But yesterday, Amram sent in a question where he wants at the bottom of every page in the footer, he wants to see the total of these amounts so far, and he wants a different total at the bottom of each printed page. Now, yesterday, I didn't actually put it in the footer, but I used a formula out here. So if you want to go with just the formula approach, go back to episode 1668. But if you want to try the macro approach, here's some steps we have to do. First, if your file is not saved as xlsm, if it's saved as xlsx, we need to save as a macro-enabled workbook. So, you know, file, save as, and then down here in the files of type, switch to Excel macro-enabled workbook. Otherwise, you're not going to be allowed to have macros in your file. Then, I recorded two macros, how to change the footer and how to print just page 2. I knew that both of those are possible in Excel, didn't know the code off the top of my head. So I recorded those macros. And then the real subject of today's podcast is how to use VBA with a loop to print just one page at a time, changing the footer in each case. All right, so I'm going to switch over to VBA, Alt F11. And let's just take a quick look down here at the two macros that I recorded. How to print just page 2. And I could have chosen any page, but it recorded this code, activewindow.selectedsheets.printout from :(2, 2, :2). So when I incorporate this in my macro, I'm going to have to change that code. All right, and then the macro recorder, you know, I love the macro recorder and I hate the macro recorder. So all I did was typed total this page in the left footer and total through this page in the right footer, and they recorded all of this stuff that I don't really need, right? Because I touched the page setup dialog box, so they recorded everything in there. We're going to shorten this significantly in our code. All right. Okay, so let's go back up to our macro. This is the macro that I want to talk about today. All right, so we start out with some things that you can fill in. Where's your first data row? It's in row 6. How many rows per page? We figured this out yesterday by looking at print preview. And of course, you want to make sure that all of your page setup is already done. And then column to total, it's column E, you'll see, is the column to total. And we want to make sure just count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's the fifth column. So you put the column number there. All right. How many rows do we have today? Well, the head row is simple. It's the first data row minus 1. Final row. This is the trick I use all the time. We go to rows.count. That's the last row in column A. This is column 1. Press the N key and the up arrow key or control up arrow key and see what row we're at. It'll tell us how many rows we have. Page count is equal to final row minus head row divided by rows per page, and that's going to be something like 8.3, right? It's hardly ever going to be perfect, so I want to round that up to get the page count. So the page count is equal to application worksheet function dot roundup. All right, so we have round in VBA, we don't have roundup, but I can use the Excel functions by using application dot worksheet function of the page count to 0 decimal places. Now that way, if it happens to be exactly 8 pages, 8.0000, I'm still going to get 8. Otherwise, I'm going to get one more. Now, here's the loop. This is the everything between for I and next I is going to happen once per page. And each time, we're going to have a variable called I that's going to indicate the page number. All right, so we figure out where the first row of data is today. That's the page number minus 1 times rows per page plus the head row plus 1. This page last row is equal to this page first row plus rows per page minus 1. And then, calculate on the fly the total for just this page, and I use cells, right, to start at this page first row, which column? Column 5, and then resize it for rows per page times I. I'm sorry, resize it for rows per page, one column, and that'll create the total for this page. To get the total of all pages, I start from the first data row and rows per page times I. So if I'm on the 7th page, 7 times 4, 280 rows. Those two variables will hold the total of this page and total of all pages. Now, we're going to change the footer. All right, so I take my copied or my recorded code down here, which has way too much in it. I get rid of all the stuff I don't need. All right, so with active sheet page setup stays, the left footer stays, the center footer goes, the right footer stays, everything else, all the way down to end width, goes away, right? Bam. So this becomes the bit of recorded code that I'm going to use over and over and over. Copy that, Control C, come up and change the footer for this page right here, Control V. But we need to put in the actual amount. So here's the recorded code. I put an ampersand and then formatted the variable total of this page with this format. You can choose whatever format you want. Total through this page, format total all pages. All right, so I'm actually changing the left footer and the right footer on the fly. Then, it's funny, I'm not just changing the footer for that page, I'm changing the footer for all pages, so I have to be very careful to only print this particular page. And then we go back up. All right, now, I'm going to run this one line at a time using F8, and I'm going to let it go through the first page because I want to show you what's happening on the second page. So here we are, this is the second time through the loop for I equals 1 to page count. So I, we're on page number 2. This page first row, right now, I have to press F8 to run it. This page first row is going to be 46. Press F8 one more time. This page last row is 85. Total this page, 95, 100. Total all pages, it's really all pages so far, 191,100. These are the exact same numbers that we were getting yesterday. All right, then here we actually go in and change the footer. All right, now at this point, let's switch back to Excel and we'll take a look at our footer. So I'll go into print and we'll zoom in right here. Total this page, 95,100. Total this page, 191,000. Has the nice commas, the two decimal places. But here's the thing. This is not the total for page one. It's incorrect. As I click through the pages, you see that the footer is the same on every single page, and that's not correct. So we have to be really, really careful here that we're only printing that particular page. So we're printing page 2. Yep, good. And we'll let the thing run. At the very bottom, then, we need to clear out the footer because maybe someday Amram won't show up to work. He's sick. He had to take his kid to school. Who knows? And someone else is going to run this code and they're not going to know about the macro and they're just going to print using Control P. And so I'm going to change that footer to use print with totals macro and so on. So here, let's run down to this point. Control F8. And we'll let the code run. And there we go. All right, so now if we go back and take a look at our page setup, so now the footers have been erased and say use print with totals macro. All right, so there we go. We have to assign this to a shortcut key, customize quick access toolbar, look for macros. There's our print with totals. We want it not for all documents, just for this document. So we'll add it. Let's see if we can modify. I don't know if there's anything in here that looks like a printer. Maybe, yeah. And change the description. Click OK. Click OK. All right, so now we have an icon up here that is print with totals. That icon will only be here when this workbook is open. All right. Very long-winded. Very tough to do in a quick little podcast here, but a macro will allow a different footer on each page. It's absolutely amazing what you can do with VBA. If you're interested in learning VBA, Tracy Sierstad and I have written a book, VBA and Macros. It's out in four different editions, Excel 2013, 2010, 2007, 2003. It's also been translated to several different languages, Spanish, Portuguese, Ukrainian, on and on and on. Also, live lessons, Excel, VBA and Macros with Mr. Excel. If you're watching the podcast, it's videos just like this one, although a lot slower, 7+ hours that you can watch, you know, 5 or 10 minutes a day and learn VBA. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.